For more than 50 years, we have struggled and failed. We've used every means in our power with nothing to show for it but pain and humiliation. And yet, our mission continues. That mission is... Kill Moose and Squirrel! Well, it's no more Mr. Nice Guy.
But Fearless Leader.
Hello! Fearless Leader, why must we kill Moose and Squirrel? What about all those years of pain and humiliation?
To be honest, I haven't had that much pain and humiliation. You're the ones in the field. My life's been pretty sweet. I went to see you two last weekend. Those guys have still got it.
But Fearless Leader, we have tried everything. Dynamite, scorpions, dynamite tied to scorpions.
Painting tunnels on sides of buildings.
Well, guess what? I put my evil genius mind to work, and at last I have the answer. To catch Moose, you must become Moose. I give you the Lady Moose Bot, a perfect killing machine and irresistible to Moose. Bad enough, you will control the Moose Bot. Then, when they least expect it, you will kill Moose and Squirrel!
He's more genius than usual. Do I control it by linking to it with some plug in my cerebral cortex?
Yeah, we were gonna do that, but we had some budget cuts.
Oh boy, here we go again.
Left our intrepid duo.
For one thing, it was 1964.
Yeah, how long did you expect us to stay frozen like this? I could use a potty break.
Ahem. Our heroes, Rocket J. Squirrel and his best pal, Bullwinkle Moose, had just crossed the impassable jungle, escaped deadly piranha, and outraced a volcano to rescue the Mayan princess.
Hola.
Moose, Squirrel in hat, you now receive our greatest honor, to be sacrificed and have your hearts plucked out.
Hokey smoke. That's a reward!
Jeepers, I'd hate to see what you fellas do for punishment.
Yeah, same thing. Only you don't get the cool necklaces.
Bullwinkle, let's get out of here!
Right behind you, Rock!
Later, in Frostbite Falls, we find our heroes receiving a Lifetime Achievement Award from their beloved mayor.
Rocky and Bullwinkle, your bravery and friendship has been an inspiration to Frostbite Falls. We would like to honor you with the key to our city.
Yay!
As presented by the enchanting Miss Moosylvania!
Smiley Whiplash, friend of the bride.
If any man or moose knows why these two should not be married, let them speak now or forever hold his peace.
Wait!
Is this the end of Bullwinkle J. Moose's bachelor days? Will Rocky the Flying Squirrel save his friend in time?
Will I ever go to normal toilet again?
Tune in next time for Another Fine Moose You've Gotten Me Into or The Man in the Iron Moose.
Here's something we hope you'll really like.
Hello there, culture lovers. Today, we take a look at the modern-day poet from Michigan named Marshall Mathers III, better known as Eminem. Here is one entitled Superman. They call me Superman. Leap tall. Superman ain't saving you. Yo-hoo. Ooh. Ooh.
Okay!
That is all for today. Next week, the complete works of Mr. 50 Cents.
Meanwhile, 3 seconds ago...
Wait!
I now pronounce you Moose and Moose. You may kiss the moose already.
Whoa! I always cry at weddings. Now, less chance to kill Moose and Scarrow.
May I?
Yes, my darling.
Pay no attention to the manatee moose's butt.
Poor Sparrow, I might have known.
Not so fast, Squirrel.
And Natasha, you're trying to kill Moose and Squirrel. I still don't understand. After all these years, why this fearless leader want to kill us anyway?
If you saw his rumpus room, you would totally get it.
Who is keeping bowling ball in here? Is a blast! I owe you one parachute. Sign Fearless Leader. Oh boy.
Any last words, Squirrel?
Look up there!
Please, that is all this tricking.
Funky smoke! Bullwinkle!
Boy, you really don't know what's inside a person till you marry him.
Well, at least no one was hurt.
True, no one was hurt. Except, of course.
It will take more than that to do in Boris Badenov. Me and my big mouth.
And so, all's well that ends well for our high-flying friend and his lowbrow companion. I think it's safe to say that these boys really put the moan in matrimony.
Oh, that's terrible.
D-Rock, you're my best pal. Let's never let anything come between us again. Rocky? Hey, Rock. Hey, Rocky. I think she likes you. Oh, 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 oh. Oh, oh,
oh. Ra ra ah, ah. Roma Roma ma, ga ga ooh la la. What's your bad romance?
Crying out loud, duck. Oh. Eh? Mother? Have you seen my bowling ball?
Did you look at your killer robot?
Once upon a time, in the little village of Pudding on the Ritz, there lived a wolf named Phox.
That's Phox with a P-H. P-H-O-X, Phox. My car.
There was no one so clever at driving a bargain.
Now this horse is exactly what you need, Grandpa. Get a 3-speed bridle, matching horseshoes, wide sidewalls. It's a steal at 40 pazoozas.
Can I look at its teeth?
Teeth? Teeth? You buying a horse? course, or a beauty queen. Come on now.
Well, all right. Here's your money.
And here's your horse.
Well, come on, horsey. Hey, I wanted a live horse.
It was alive, but I didn't say when.
Nobody liked the fox with the PH, but nobody could ever get the better of him. One day, the sly fox was tripping through the woods.
Oh, hearty, har, har.
When he chanced upon a mysterious box sitting in an open glade. On its top was written this strange legend.
To take my treasure, you may try, but he who opens me shall die. A treasure chest! Oh, gadzooks, I'm in luck! Ooh, but whoever opens it shall die. Ergo, I gotta get some dummy to open it for me. But who would be that much of a nitwit? Ow! Ow! Ow!
Desmond Dolwit wasn't exactly the village idiot.
Ow! But I came in second, Desmond! Oh, buddy! Ow! I need somebody to open a box for me. No, you don't. Whoever opens that box is gonna die. How'd you know that?
Well, I was, listening to the first part of the story, you know?
Oh, so I ain't gonna open it. Oh, but you must, Desmond. That box holds a beautiful princess who was put under a spell by a wicked witch, remember? Well, listen.
Little did Desmond know that the wily fox was an accomplished ventriloquist.
Help! Help me, Desmond!
Right in that place. And there is somebody in there. Hey, how does she know my name?
Why, she's been secretly in love with you for years.
Oh, joy bells. Hang on, honey. Love a pumpkin is here.
Sainted Aunt Hannah. Oh, look at that. Gold jewelry. Queen Victoria's spittoon. I'm rich, rich.
I don't see no princess, Mr. Fox.
Of course not, you stupid lox. It was a joke, get it? Well, here, you go get yourself a big croaker sack, and we'll divide all the treasure. Half and half, even Steven. 1820.
Yeah, all right. But I'd rather have a princess.
No sooner had Desmond gone than the wily fox pulled out a croaker sack of his own and began filling it with the priceless treasure. Meanwhile, Desmond wandered through the lavender glen looking for a croaker sack. There he chanced upon a beautiful milkmaid.
Ow! Yeah, hi there, Missy. You wouldn't happen to have an old croaker sack on you, would you?
Why, I'm wearing one.
Yeah, I just need it to put my priceless treasure into.
Priceless treasure? Just a minute, honey. Here you are.
Ooh, thanks a bunch.
Wait for me, lover pumpkin.
The smarmy fox had filled his sack when he noticed one small coin left in the chest.
An Indian head penny.
Of course, the greedy fox had to have it.
Are you kidding? They bring three pazoozas on the open market.
But in reaching for that last penny, Fox overbalanced and...
Here I am, Mr. Fox. Oh, looky. He must have left my share for me. But where'd he go?
I'm in the box. Let me out.
Sure you are. Hey, what a kidder.
Get me out of here.
Well, thanks for divvying it up with me, Mr. Fox. Wherever you are.
And the stupid lox ambled off, followed by the beautiful milkmaid.
Hold up, sugarfoot!
Years later, whenever anyone would ask about the fox with the PH, the answer was always the same.
Who cares?
As for Desmond Dolwit, he and his beautiful wife lived happily...
Ow!
...to a ripe old age.
Wait a minute! The legend said that whoever opened the box would die.
Yep. But it didn't say when.